Good day, everyone. So this is Alvin again from the Philippines, and today, welcome to another edition of Miss Universe 2019 Contestants Profile Review and Analysis. And today, we are going to talk about Miss Universe Namibia 2019. And since Namibia belongs to the Asia-Pacific and African region, here is my current ranking for that group. And that ranking will change at the end of this video depending if Namibia will qualify in my personal top 10. But here's a clue, you have to watch until the end because there's going to be an interesting shuffle in the ranking. So let's begin. Namibia started competing in 1981. They already have won once, and that was in 1992 with Michelle McLean. Their latest placement was in 2003 with Indapewa Alphonse, who finished in the top 10. And this year, they just crowned Nadja Breytenbach. She's 24 years old. And on her profile, here's what I got online. During her psychology honors internship program in 2018, she was given the privilege to work at a child trauma counseling center and at a primary school. Both centers focuses in aiding the underprivileged children in Cape Town communities. She also started working with House Merua Children's Home, where she conducts a confidence and self-esteem workshop with the amazing and young ladies. To me, that actually sounds like a very, very interesting profile, and I would love to know more about it. My advice would be, if that is going to be the profile that she will bring to Miss Universe, I certainly hope that she will make it stronger for the competition. And as a follower of her in Instagram, I really would love to see more updates about it. And if there are other advocacies that she's been working with, or other charities and organizations that she's been working with, I really hope Nadja will share it on her Instagram account. For those who are following her in Instagram will be aware as well on the things that she's been working with, especially for the upcoming Miss Universe 2019 pageant. Now for the national pageant, I really did not follow Miss Universe Namibia 2019, and I just opted to wait for the final result. Well, for Nadja, I think she is beautiful. But at the same time, and same as the other contenders as well, I would love to give the same comment, which is, I would love to see consistency when it comes to their beauty, when it comes to their styling. But I understand that as well, because I know other ladies are also experimenting other styling on which will work with them and which will make them stand out in Miss Universe. So for her styling, there are really photos of her where her styling looked great. And I saw a photo of her as well where her hairstyle was styled in a bun type, and I loved it because it gave emphasis to her face and highlighted how beautiful she is. But I would love to see her work on different styling as well and experiment in it and find a proper styling which will make her look like a real standout on the competition. And having said that though, I do think she looked beautiful during her crowning in the national pageant. I just don't like the black dress. I don't get that. I don't like the styling of that dress as well. But from neck going up, she just looks stunning. Beautiful face. Her face is also very, very sweet looking, which I really, really love. But aside from the beautiful face that she got, I don't know how she is when it comes to personality and confidence, but I would love to see her in a more confident but humble version of herself, and as someone with great personality as well. Because in these recent editions of Miss Universe pageant, even in other pageants, everyone is beautiful. So it's definitely a battle on who's got the most beautiful personality, confidence, and attitude. So personality is everything when it comes to pageants. When it comes to her walk and to her performance, I cannot comment on it as well because I have not seen any video clips of her walking in swimsuits and even in evening gown. But I would just give some general advice to Nadja. Work on her walk, especially when it comes to swimsuit and evening gown. Again, a great walk accompanied by a great stage presence, confidence, and personality. And also, I really hope she is great in interviews. because that's one important thing in Miss Universe and IMG. They really wanted a great speaker, and as what you noticed last year, everyone in the top 20 did an amazing interview with Steve Harvey and did an amazing speech as well, with the exception of Jamaica. But we understood why it happened, because sometimes nerves are just an obstacle. But that doesn't mean that if you cannot give a great speech, you're stupid or you're dumb, because even how smart you are, there will always be some questions that you cannot answer. So let's give some ladies some slack, especially to Jamaica last year. But then again, going back to Nadia, work on her interviews and make it as appealing, convincing, and believable as possible. And with Michelle McLean winning Miss Universe in 1992 and judging Miss Universe 2018, I certainly hope that she'll become a part of the training and preparation of Nadia, because I am confident that she could contribute a lot and potentially help her country pull another placement in Miss Universe. Their last placement was in 2003, so that was almost two decades ago. They really need to get another placement. And even if Africa and Asia Pacific is a strong region, with proper guidance, training, and preparation, I truly believe Nadia could pull a placement, because she's got the potentials to do it. So having said that, here is my new and updated ranking for Asia Pacific and Africa. As what they have said, there's a lot of shuffling. My number 10 is Australia. My number 9 is Sierra Leone, so she went back to my top 10. Number 8 is China. Number 7 is Myanmar. 6 is Namibia. I'll just put her at this spot as of the moment. Number 5 is Malaysia. 4 is Vietnam. 3 is Philippines. 2 is Indonesia. And my number 1 still for Asia, Pacific, and Africa is Thailand. So this has become my mini prediction per region. So what do you think? If you wanted to know my reviews of these contestants, and of course other contestants from other regions as well, you can just go ahead and check on my channel. And I have also created my personal playlist, where you can see all of my reviews of the Miss Universe 2019 contestants. So what do you think? Don't forget to leave your comments below. Don't forget to give a thumbs up and share the video as well. And most importantly, don't forget to subscribe, because you'll be seeing more of these videos in the future. So for now, thank you very much, and have a wonderful day from the Philippines.